I got spanked and I turned out fine.
Spare the rod, spoil the child. Kids today need to be beat. What else am I supposed to do?
He's so bad.
Ooh, she gets on my last nerve.
Better hush up before I give you something to cry about.
It was important that I write the book, Beating Black Kids.
This, I'm old-fashioned. And I believe, you know, you just can't let a child do anything.
I think it's okay, long you don't abuse them.
It's needed to a certain point.
But what I saw was a collection of adults who were talking about a topic they had never really talked about before. And out came, my mama used to hit me with a spatula. My dad used to hit me with a belt. They used to make me get wet first. They used to put my face in a pillow and then spank me. Like, all of these different stories about how we have gotten beaten over time. And while there was a lot of laughter when those stories were being told, I could clearly see that there's a fine line between laughing and crying. And I knew that it was time for me to write a book about handling the situation. And so it's very obvious that this came from being a slave, from a slavery experience, from that whole spare the rod, spoil the child. The shepherd did not beat the sheep with the rod. He guided them with the rod. And so it is just obvious that that came from a slavery experience, and we have to know how to differentiate those things and then just use some discernment in terms of doing what's best for our children and not breaking their spirits. With regards to how we discipline our children, first of all, I always tell people that discipline, if you look at the etymology of the word, it comes from disciplina, which is the Latin root meaning teach. And so when you discipline a child, you are teaching them. But when you use corporal punishment and you hit our children, you're not teaching them anything. They're actually not going to do it again out of fear. They're not doing it out of reason. The frustration that we feel from being powerless in a society and all of the things that come along with that, those issues are not to be taken out on our children when we get home. The definition of domestic violence says bringing harm to someone in your home or hurting someone in your home. So I want us to look at how we beat our offspring and how that's not giving them anything good. It's making them quote unquote obedient, but that's what you make a dog, that's what you make an animal. But when you're dealing with someone of higher intelligence, use their intelligence and start to talk to them in ways that give them power, make them feel supported, listen to their ideas, and it'll just be an easier parenting road for you. There's a part of the brain called the regulatory part of the brain, and that's the part of the brain that helps you make decisions in times of adversity. Well, if they have that toxic stress before they're even four, that part of the brain does not develop. And so you're looking at a community full of people with no regulatory equipment. So we need to be bringing a different generation of people up with a different consciousness. Make sure that the kids feel good and alive while they're living. Don't be upset after they die and after there's all these senseless killings. Let's treat them well while they're living, and then we'll see a different impact. The adults want to be upset, but you taught the children the violence when they were young, and it's the tools they have. I feel like, you know, hitting children is such a skillless. We need to foster behavior that builds them up and that just changes the way, like, we talk to each other. Talk to your
discipline
child.
Because discipline, we're using it a lot to describe hitting children. And this is not directly to you, LaShawn, but it's to just all of us because I've heard it and it's personally and discipline.
My book is sold in Switzerland, Germany, Tasmania, Nigeria, Sudan, Canada, all over the world. And so people all over the world are telling me, as far as Germany, that my book is making a difference in the lives of the people that other people touch, but also in the lives of many parents and families who now no longer beat their children because they read my book. A lot of people ask me if I'm going to write another book, and I'm not ready to write another book, but what I will say is that there is a high demand for the book in Spanish and in French. My book is not punitive, my book is not accusatory, but there are solutions replete throughout the whole book. It really is just about being engaged with your child. They're not going to become respectful and trustworthy through you telling them and demanding it. They're going to become that way from observing you and then emulating what they see. And so in my parental code of ethics that I wrote, one of my favorite lines is, I will only seek excellence in my child if I am excellent myself. And so that's what I say is the number one key to make sure you have great children is checking yourself.
Thank you.